Welcome to My Easy Statistics. In this video, I am going to discuss about solving linear programming problem using simplex method. Minimization case. I am taking an example of minimization case. This is to solve the following LPP using simplex method for optimal solution. The objective function is minimize z is equal to x1 minus 3 x2 plus 2 x3. Subject to constraint, there are three constraints are there and they are less than or equal to. Now first we are going to convert the constraints from canonical form to standard form. So if we take the first constraint, which is less than or equal to, by adding slack variable s1, the inequality becomes equality. And the second constraint, where we have less than or equal to, same way we must add the second slack variable, then the inequality has become into equality. Same procedure for the third constraint. So in this way we are going to convert the constraints which are in less than or equal to equality by adding slack variables. So we have s1, s2 and s3 are slack variables. Now coming to objective function, we have minimization. Multiply both sides by minus 1. Then what will happen? The minimization case will become maximization. And now you must read it as minus z is equal to minus x1 plus 3x2 minus 2x3. Now if you take minus z is equal to z0, then maximization z0 is equal to minus x1 plus 3x2 minus 2x3. Now this is the case which you are going to become objective function maximization. Z0 is equal to minus x1 plus 3x2 minus 2x3 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3. The coefficients of slack variables we have considered as 0. Now this is the basic setting which we need to do to solve the minimization case. Now from here onwards, we need to solve the problem simplex method as maximization case only. Now we'll start the simplex table. This is the initial table where we have basic variables as s1, s2, s3. Cj are coefficient of objective functions. So this is maximization objective function. We have constraints, three constraints I am showing here. First constraint, second constraint and third constraint. Now the coefficients in the objective functions I am substituting here as Cj, minus 1, plus 3, minus 2, 0, 0 and 0. So in the objective functions, what coefficients I have here, I am substituting in this place. Now Cb I am drawing here. Cb, coefficient of basic variables. S1, S2, S3 are basic variables. Now what coefficients we have here? 0, 0 and 0. The same variables, the coefficients are substituted here. Next we go with objective function. The objective function, after objective function, constraints. 3x1 minus x2 plus 2x3 plus s1 is equal to 7. Now these coefficients I am going to substitute here. See, my 3 minus 1 plus 2, 0. And s1, s2 are 0. So the same coefficient I got as 0 and 0. and solution is 7. So I got 3 here, minus 1, 2 and 1, S1 is 1 and I don't have S2 and S3 in this, so I'm keeping it as 0. Solution is 7. And next constraint, minus 2, plus 4, 0. S1 is not there, S2 is 1 and S3 is 0. So you can see this way. The coefficient of the second constraint are taken here. Solution is 12. Third constraint. So I'm going to take as minus 4, plus 3, 8, 0, 0, 1 and 10. So these coefficients I am substituting in this place. Now next we are going to calculate ZJ. Now how to calculate ZJ? Here I got a 0. How I got is CB value must take, which is 0, into X1 value 3, 0 into minus 2, 0 into minus 4. That sum we are going to get the value here. Just I'll write here and show you. Zero into 3 plus minus 2 into 0 plus minus 4 into 0. The total will come 0. Now this is how we are calculating ZJ value. I'm multiplying 0 into 3, 0 into minus 2, 0 into 4. If I take the sum, I'm going to get 0. In the same way, second also. 0 into minus 1, 0 into 4, 0 into 3. Sum it. We are going to get 0. The same way, you calculate ZJ value for all the variables. Now, this is what we got ZJ value. Next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to calculate CJ minus ZJ. Where is CJ? Minus 1. Minus 1, minus 0. How much it is? Minus 1. Next, 3. Next, minus 2. 0, 0 and 0. Have I got CJ minus ZJ? CJ is minus 1. Minus 0, minus 1. 3 minus 0, 3. Minus 2 minus 0. So this is what we are going to get the values of CJ minus ZJ. Now here important condition need to be checked. To check whether the solutions what we have is optimal or not, we need to consider the condition, that is CJ minus ZJ must be less than or equal to 0. Let me check. Is all values less than or equal to 0? No. 3 is a value which is positive value and which is not less than or equal to 0. Means the solution what I got is not optimal solution. Now I am going to highlight that particular variable X2 and I call this variable as entering variable. X2 I am going to call as entering variable. Now next step is we need to find the values for ratio. To get the ratio values, the solution value need to be divided by its corresponding column value. Solution value is 7. Divide it by minus 1. We get minus 7. 12 divided by 4, 3. 10 divided by 3. Now this is called ratio value. When we have an entering variable, we need to have leaving variable. How to identify leaving variable is in the ratio, select a variable which is least non-negative value. This is negative value, so you must not consider this variable as leaving. 3 and 10 by 3, this is the least value. So S2 is called as leaving variable. So the least non-negative ratio is selected as leaving variable. And I am highlighting with orange color. So I have two variables. X2 is entering and S2 is leaving. So this variable is going out. Now in its place, I am going to get X2. Right. In this way, I'm going to get X2. Now from initial simplex table, I'm going to create the first iteration table. Now we will discuss how to create the values for these variables. First, we shall see about CB values. Why we got zero value? Because S1 coefficient here is what? Zero. X2, what is the coefficient? 3. And S3 coefficient is 0. So in this place I get 0, 3 and 0. Fine. Now what is a new variable that I have entered? X2. In place of S2, I got X2. Now let me calculate the values of X2 in the new table. I got minus 2 by 4, 1, 0, 0, 1 by 4. And 0 and even 3. How I got these values is, take these values. We have a common value between the column and the row. You can see I highlighted with the green color 4. This element is called key element. So the key element in my case is 4. Now divide all the values by 4. Then you will get the new variable values. Minus 2 by 4, 4 by 4, 0 by 4, 0 by 4, 1 by 4, 0 by 4 and 12 by 4. Then I am going to get the new values. So this is a simple method which you must follow to calculate the values of new entering variable. Divide the old values by key element value. That's it. Now in place of S2, I got X2. Take the key element, divide all the values by 4. Then automatically I am going to get these values. Now the next task is how to find the values of old values S1 and S3. There is a simple method is there. I'll show it. This way you must find. Remember this formula. The new value is equal to old value minus key column value into key row value divided by key element. Now, if I want to get this value, for example, I got 5 by 2. How I got 5 by 2? We must take the old value as 3 minus. This is row and this is column. For this value, what is the row? Minus 2. For this value, what is the column? Minus 1 divided by 4. That's it. 3 minus minus 2 into minus 1 divided by 4. So I'm going to get 5 by 2. So I'm writing here the value 5 by 2. Now next we'll see the next value. I got 0. How I got 0? The old value is minus 1. Minus. What is the column value? Minus 1. What is the row value? 4. Divide by key element. Key element is 4. See, for this total variable S1, minus 1 will be constant. The column value will be always be constant. Minus 1 will be there. And element will be constant, only the row value will be changing. So minus 1 minus minus 1 into 4 divided by 4. What is the value I'm going to get? 0. So I got 0. In the same way, I must find the value for the third value, 2. How I got 2? 2 minus, okay, we need to, I'll do the calculation, I'll show you once again. So here the old value is 2 minus minus 1, because for this the column value is minus 1 into, what is the row value? 0 divided by 4. So 2 minus 0 is equal to 2. I got 2 value here. In the same way, calculate the complete values using the formula. New value need to be found with old value minus key column value into key row value divided by key element. Now in the same procedure, find the values for S3 also. Like this, I'm going to get minus 5/2, 0, 8, 0, minus 3/4, 1, and solution is 1. Now I have found the new values. Now let me calculate ZJ value. How to calculate ZJ value? Multiply 0 into 5/2 plus 3 into minus 2/4 plus 0 into minus 5/2. This is how we got the value. 0 into 5/2, 0 into 5/2 plus 3 into minus 2/4 and plus 0 into 5/2. So I got minus 6/4, which is nothing but minus 3/2. ZJ value need to be found with the formula, and this is how I got all the ZJ values. Now CJ minus ZJ. What is CJ? CJ is minus 1, 3, minus 2, 0 and 0. Now do the values calculations. Yes, I got CJ minus ZJ. Now to identify whether the solution what I got is optimal or not, I need to use the condition. What is the condition? CJ minus ZJ should be less than or equal to 0. In this case, this is not less than or equal to 0. This is satisfied. This also satisfied. This also satisfied. Minus 3/4 satisfied. And even 0 is satisfied. But this value is not satisfied. Means x1 is going to now enter into simplex table. Now this is what I am going to do. X1 highlighted with yellow color. Why I have highlighted? Because CJ minus ZJ is not less than or equal to 0. So x1 is entering. Now what value will leave the table? So to do that one, I need to calculate the ratio value. How to calculate ratio value? The entering variable values, that is 5/2, minus 2/4, minus 5/2. These are the values. Divide the corresponding solution value. That is 10 divided by 5/2, it is 4. 3 divided by minus 2/4, minus 6. Next, 1 divided by minus 5/2, it is minus 2/5. Now, in the ratio values, we need to ignore negative values, only consider non-negative value, and we need to select the least non-negative value. What is the least non-negative value? 4. So this colored one, which is brown colored one, is called as leaving variable. And between this column and row, 5/2 is called key element. So S2 is leaving outside, and we are going to get X1 in its place. So now I am going to move to second iteration table. So this is the second iteration table. From the first iteration table values, I am going to generate second iteration values. Now you can see in place of S1, I got X1. X2 is old value, is there already. S3 is also there. So first insert the coefficient of basic variables. So X1 is having minus 1. X2 is having 3. S3 is having, what is the value it has? 0. So these values are kept here. Now let me calculate first the new variable values. How to calculate the new variable values? Take the key element value, which is 5/2. Divide all the other values by 5/2. Then you get 5/2 divide by 5/2 is 1. 0 by 5/2, 0. 2 by 5/2, 4/5. 1 divided by 5/2, 2/5. 1/4 divided by 2/5, 1/10. 0 by something is 0. 10 divided by 5/2, it is 4. In this way, we need to calculate the new entered value. Now, next we need to calculate the values for x2 and s3. How to do this calculation is, we use a formula already. New value is equal to old value minus key column value into key row divided by key element. Use a formula and find these values. I have already explained in the same video how to calculate these values. Use a formula. New value is equal to old value minus key element into key column divided by key element. Key element in our case, in this case, is 5/2. Right. After getting these values, calculate ZJ value. ZJ value, how we calculate? Multiply minus 1 into 1 plus 3 into 0 plus 0 into 0. Add these values, we get ZJ value. Minus 1, 3, 2 by 5, 1 by 5, 4 by 5, and 0. Now, next to calculate CJ minus ZJ. CJ is minus 1 minus minus 1. We get 0, 0, minus 2 by 5, minus 1 by 5, minus 4 by 5, and 0. Now I got CJ minus ZJ value. Now, is the solution what I got is optimal or not? We need to check the condition. To check the condition, CJ minus ZJ should be less than or equal to 0. Is the condition satisfied? Yes. Means what solution I got here is called optimal solution. X1 is 4, X2 is 5, S3 is 11. But we don't consider in the solution. Let us see this. X1 is 4, X2 is 5. In the solution, we don't have X3. So X3 will take as 0. And substitute these values in the objective function. Z0 is equal to, this is an equation. Substitute in this equation, we get Z0 is equal to 11. Now, where Z0 is equal to what? Minus Z. So Z is equal to minus 11. This is the optimal solution. The optimal solution is minus 11.